In this video, we will detail how to create a new site with Composer and how to convert an existing site to use Composer. At the end of this lesson, you will be able to understand the steps involved in creating a new Composer-based site and understand the changes required to convert an existing site to start using Composer. To generate a new site using Composer, we need to run through a few command-based steps and then some manual setup. To start with, we need to ensure that we have Composer and Git installed in our local development environment. The most straightforward way to achieve this is to use brew. The following commands should install all our required tools at their latest versions. For Drupal 8 and Drupal 9, you should use the Composer template at drupal/recommended-project. This template ensures that Drupal core dependencies are the exact same version as the official Drupal release. We'll use this recommended project as part of our first command, composer create project, drupal/recommended-project, my project. This will use our new installation of Composer to create a new project based on drupal/recommended-project. The last argument is the name we wish to give the project. For this example, I've selected my project. We can specify a particular version at this point by supplying a version with the Drupal recommended argument. You can view a full list of available versions on Packagist or run the following command to find them via Composer. Once Composer has generated a new project, we then need to navigate to our new project using the cd command. Before we start adding modules, we first need to run a few Composer commands to make some initial recommended settings. Running composer config vendor-dir vendor will configure the location and name of the vendor directory. Running composer config repositories.1 composer and the following address will add assetpackages.org as an additional repository to provide access to packages in addition to those hosted on drupal.org. Packagist is also a requirement as Composer cannot access Drupal packages without this definition. Running composer config preferred-install dist will set the install method Composer will prefer to use. The options are auto, source, or dist. For our purposes, and for downloads from drupal.org, we should set this to dist. There are many other settings which can be added to the config section of the Composer JSON file. The full list can be found here. Now we've created the project and made some initial settings, we can now start adding some new modules and themes by running the composer require command, the format for which is composer require drupal/module-name. To get us started, here are some recommended projects to add which will be applicable to most sites and use cases. Converting an existing non-composer Drupal site to a composer-managed build is a relatively straightforward process. There are only a few things that need to be changed. First, the vendor directory, located in the doc root, needs to be moved one level above, so it's in the project root and above the doc root. Second, you need to alter the autoload.php file found in the doc root to point to the new location of the vendor directory. Lastly, once these small changes have been implemented, we then need a valid composer.json file and composer.lock placed above the doc root. You may not have a composer.log file at this stage, which is fine, because whenever you run a composer update or composer require command, composer will generate a new log file or write to an existing one. With all the structural changes complete, we should also verify that the top level .gitignore file doesn't have any entries which would prevent Git from committing the vendor, modules, or core directories. If these locations were specified in the gitignore, we would likely face site-breaking errors when pushing to Acquia hosting, as files necessary for the site to function could be missing. We'll cover how to populate and configure a composer JSON file in a separate video, but if you'd like an example file to base your site on, one can be found at the following address. In this lesson, we discussed how to set up Composer for use with new sites as well as existing ones. Recall our objectives for this lesson.